My name is Arnaud Reveilloux, working for Subsea 7, and I'm acting as EHTF project manager. If I want to speak simply about EHTF, it's a technology based on, I would say, unusual or domestic technology by using electrical wires providing energy to or heating through FA joule. We first use a pipe-in-pipe technology that is commonly used on the North Subsea markets, where we introduce into the annulus some electrical wires led simply onto the pipe, and passing a current into those wires create heating by a simple joule effect. There is many reasons for using EHTF technology developed by Subsea 7 and ITP. First, we are offering as an experienced and recognized EPCI contractors established on the market but for delivering for many decades very complex projects. We do have track records in developing new technology for projects. Speaking and focusing more about EHTF, we first offer a very efficient pipe-in-pipe solution by using the ISOFLEX technology, which is this material combined to reduce pressure environments, providing very efficient thermal performances that allow for very compact and optimized pipe-in-pipe cross-sections already for your operating conditions. The EHTF qualification program is built following oil and gas industry standards and taking into account client specification. We need, of course, the support of company because we need to understand what you need and to integrate in our technology to fit with and to suit with your needs, because we are not developing a technology, we are developing a technology fit for project purpose. Ensuring having the fluids arriving from the reservoirs up to the topside today and running for very, very long distance is not possible by using standard insulation methods. And this is only EHTF capable to, by introducing permanent heating to offset and providing more energy to the flowline and the fluid to allow for these long tiebacks. Otherwise, It would require the development of new topside facilities, and which is a matter of very expensive and costly solutions. And we can imagine easily today for having existing platform or even in end life platforms with neighborhood reservoirs to be connected via those long tiebacks simply using EHTF solution. The positive counterpart of the low power requirements and our configurations is that we do not require for very huge modification onto the top sides, and in some cases only standard electrical cabinets, which are small sizing rooms, and also taking opportunity to be connected to an urgency system to maintain always, in any case, EHTF operability, whatever partial or full shutdown of the platform. Today, in terms of direct CapEx benefits, we removed all these ancillaries, equipments, only leaving and focusing on the production units. And during operations, when we do have a shutdown, it's just a matter of switching on the EHTF system, putting the fluid in temperatures, and at time of restart, just switching off and having direct access to the production. Do see within Subsea 7 a double challenger in between, that we are able to create, but we are also able to improve. Technology has no frontier. Technology is game changer to stretch all the limits to suit with more and more challenging projects, either to get access to inaccessible reserves or reducing cost of project. In the end, EHTF works on both fronts to offer to our clients an enabling and available cost-effective technology.